Hello, I'm Dr. Susan Hamer and I'm the National Director for Nursing, Midwifery and the Allied Health Professions, and I particularly look after the world that is about informatics and technology for the Department of Health. I really welcome this opportunity to talk to you because I want to talk to you about something that I've got increasingly passionate about. And I have been working very specifically in this area for the last 2 years, 2.5 years. And over that time, I've got increasingly not only passionate but concerned about how we engage more nurses, and more nurses have within their own ideas a vision about how technology can enable their practice. And that's really what I want to just spend a few minutes talking to you about. So why is informatics important? Well, informatics basically is about how we use information and technology. And you can see that throughout your entire career today, you have always used information and technology. On a certain way, it's nothing new. What is new is the scale of change and the pace of change, and the fact that we have some very real changes in how we're organising our services, which will make it even more important that technology and information connect patients and carers with the services that they would wish to use, and that nursing will have a very important role to play in that interface. And that is potentially very, very exciting, but also presents us with some challenges. So as we think about the information and technology landscape, there are some very real challenges for nursing. I think often the media gets hung up on the fact that it's about the kit, about the computers and about the laptops. In actual fact, I think some of that challenge is ours, and particularly in acute settings, I think there is a real challenge on having technology that works how nurses work. But I think probably the bigger challenge is the cultural challenge. It is about how we start to think about our practice and think about practicing in a very different way, where patients and carers are using information and we enable them to navigate that information to develop the sort of services that they would wish to see, and that we ourselves perhaps let go of some of the things that we currently gatekeep, and to enable patients to do that for themselves. So some really exciting challenges for nurses, but one where if we're not in the room, we won't get asked the questions. And I think that takes me to another point that has been a concern of mine over the last few years, is it has been really quite difficult to engage nurses in a conversation about information and technology. And I think that has been a lot to do with our comfort around some of the language. And I think we have really got to start to challenge our own thinking in this space and to support one another to be much more confident about having conversations about what's the information we want. And what, more importantly, what is the information that we need? What's the information we need to drive quality? What's the information we need to care for patients? If you as a practitioner are finding yourself putting the same information in the same way onto a different piece of paper and it's the fifth time, then that's not good enough. So what is it that we are doing which actually stops some of these practices that we've got ourselves into and really challenges them? Because what we need is high quality data, ideally put in once at point of care, because that's the most accurate way of recording data, and then that way I think we can have a really good commitment to high standards of data quality. So my challenge really is also to think about, so what's your vision for nursing? What's your vision for technology as an enabler to nursing? And I don't think I sit here for 1 minute thinking that this is going to put any nurse out of a job. I think there's plenty of work out there for all of us. But what I think it might let us do is let go of some aspects of our role while we focus maybe on the more complex and on those areas where we really, really have got the skills to apply to nursing practice. So if it's routine and if it is essentially administrative function, then increasingly technology should just be able to do that for you. And that means that, again, we need to be having a conversation with other people about designing systems That will enable and free up frontline practitioners to work with their expert skills and to work with patients in a high quality way. So, what does this mean for you, and how can you practically get involved? On the upside, if you're watching, me, then that's a good first step. But there's numerous ways that you can get involved, and we have an NHS network site, and the link will be associated with this. But there are also lots of local people who we've got on those networks who are willing to have a conversation. We also increasingly have a network of mentors and coaches, and again through the network you can get hold of that. And we also have a National Strategic Task Force which is working hard to try and make sure that we have a good strategic view about what some of this needs to look like, but also works actively to engage frontline practitioners in that conversation, which is about our future. We have a strategy for information that has just been launched, and that provides us a very real platform to go back into our organisations and have a conversation which is about how we get involved. And we need to be fostering through the system nurses who have a passion about data, a passion about standards, and who have patient safety in the core of what they do, and who have an interest in developing information and technology. And if you meet any of those criteria and you would like a little bit more help in terms of getting yourself into this landscape and much more active in this landscape, then do feel free to contact us, because we really, really need many more people. We need this to be a leaderful landscape, not just a few leaders' landscape. Thank you for your time.